Functions of Reserve Bank of India. So we all know that the Reserve Bank is the central bank of our country, and as such it has all the typical functions of a good and proper central bank. Now the function of the Reserve Bank of India can be broadly divided under three broad categories. The first being the central banking functions. Under the central banking functions, we have the following sub-functions. Number one, issue of bank notes. So, the RBI has the sole right to issue bank notes of all denominations except 1 rupee notes. And this is under the section 22 of the RBI Act. So, this has been given to the RBI to have a complete and uniform control over the currency and credit system of the country. Thus, we can say that except the 1 rupee note, all other notes are printed by the RBI. And the RBI has four places where these currencies are printed. They are Currency Note Press Nashik, Bank Note Press Devas, Modernized Currency Note Press Mysore, and Modernized Currency Note Press Shalboni. So these are the four areas or four places at which currently the bank uses to print notes. Number two, banker to the government. The RBI also acts as a banker to the government, and as a result it also acts as a banker to the government and provides certain various functions, like it provides deposits account of the central and state governments, it receives and collects revenue and payment, it also makes payment on behalf of the central and state governments. The RBI also acts as an agent to the government, and as an agent it collects tax and other payments, raises loans from the public, also transfers funds. The RBI also acts as an advisor, and thus it helps the government in formulating the economic, monetary, financial and fiscal policy by its experience and knowledge. Number three, Bankers Bank. The Reserve Bank of India also serves as the Bankers Bank to the scheduled commercial banks, and thus it helps in acting as a custodian of the cash reserves of the banks. That is, the banks have to maintain a certain percentage of their total deposits with the Reserve Bank. The Reserve Bank is also lender of the last resort. Thus, the Reserve Bank of India grants financial assistance to all the scheduled banks in the form of rediscounting or purchasing of eligible bills, loans and advances. These functions of RBI enables it to exercise its control over the banking system of the country. And also, the RBI acts as the clearing house. A clearing house may be defined as an organization of banks constituted for the purpose of settling interbank liabilities due to transfer of deposits. Thus, RBI acts as the clearing house for settlement of banking transactions, and in this way it acts as the banker's bank. Number four, custodian of gold and foreign exchange reserves. The RBI has the sole authority to enter into foreign exchange transactions both on its own and on behalf of the government, and thereby it helps in keeping the stocks of gold and foreign exchange reserves of the country. Controller of credit. The RBI also acts as the controller of credit by exercising its quantitative and qualitative instruments, which helps in controlling the flow of credit in the economy. Number B, supervisory function. In addition to its traditional central banking functions, the RBI also performs certain non-monetary functions of the nature, that is, supervisory functions. Under this function, the certain sub-functions are licensing of banks. So it is with the help of RBI that a bank gets its license. Approval of capital reserves and liquid asset of banks. So RBI ensures that each and every bank has the minimum requirements of capital reserve and liquid assets. Inspection, control over management and methods, audit, control over amalgamation and liquidity. Implementing the deposit insurance scheme are some of the functions which comes under the supervisory functions. Number C, promotional functions. So apart from the central banking functions and supervisory functions, the Reserve Bank of India also performs certain promotional functions. So they are the promotional steps taken by the RBI in this direction can be summarized as it has promoted commercial banking and has taken steps to put India banking system on sound footing. It has also promoted cooperative banking, agricultural and rural credit banking, also by promotes industrial finance by taking steps in development and establishment of specialized institutions like IFCI, SDBI or SFCs, and also the NABARD Bank and regional rural banks. The RBI has also established the bill market scheme in 1952 to develop the bill market. Thus, we can say that the RBI plays a very important role in maintaining and stability in the financial as well as the economical and monetary situation of a country by controlling, supervising and also helping by giving advice.